So Velcro is called Velcro because he follows you around everywhere you go. He sticks right to you. And Velcro, he used to live with us in a town called Houston, all the way down in Texas. And in his town, he had a backyard. He loved to run and to play. And in Houston, he had made all kinds of friends. And these are his three best friends. The first one was the first cat he ever made friends with. His name was Charlie. Charlie used to sit in the yard with Velcro. And here's a little thing about cats. Cats don't meow at each other. They only meow to us. But what they do is they stare at one another. And Charlie taught Velcro all the secrets about staring the longest. And they could sit out there for hours. And they would stare and stare. Stare, and stare, and stare, and you get the point. And Velcro's other friend was the first friend that he made that wasn't a cat, and was a very friendly marsupial named Awesome Possum. And Awesome Possum lives up in the trees, so she loves to climb up high on top of fences, on top of power lines, and she loved to give Velcro advice. And the other friend that Velcro made was the smallest friend he made of all. His name was Corey, and Corey was a roach. Corey, even though he was small, he was very wise. He'd been all around, and he knew all sorts of things, and he helped Velcro anytime he had any trouble. And those were his three best friends in Houston. Now one day, Velcro was out prancing and playing in his yard when he thought, hey, I'm tired, I'm gonna go home. And he ran into his house. And when he got up there, things were different. So not only did he see his stuff, he started to see boxes pile up all around the place. And he was used to seeing his people pack up clothes and put them into suitcases. And they did that, but they did something else that was very weird. They started to take everything off the walls and off the shelves, put it into boxes, tape them up, and pack them up. And they even took the cushions right off the couch. And this was weird, because Velcro had never seen these people do this before. And when he got in the apartment, he started to look around, and sniff, and wonder how long these boxes were gonna stay in the middle of everything. And that made him really worried. He didn't know what to do. And so he just walked around everything. And he thought, hey, I'll go ask my friends what's happening. Maybe they can help me. So he ran outside as fast as he could. And when he got back outside, he found his friend, Awesome Possum. She was walking along the fence, just like that. Oh, Awesome Possum, I'm so happy to see you.
Well, hello, Velcro. Say hello, babies. Hello.
Awesome Possum, I was wondering if you can help me. My people, they're packing everything up into boxes. And I'm used to packing their clothes and putting them into suitcases and going away for a while. But this time, they're packing up everything, including the cushions on the couch.
Oh wow, I never heard of that before. Us possums, we like to stay put. But you know what? I bet you Charlie could help you out. I'll go get him, wait here.
So Velcro waited. Charlie came. Velcro, just put clothes in a suitcase, and sometimes I'll move the suitcase out, and I love to sleep on it like a bed.
Well, me too.
But yeah, but I've never heard of them putting stuff into boxes and taking things off the walls. You know who might be able to help? Corey. I'll go get him. Velcro waited. Corey jumped right out. Velcro, I heard you need some help. Yeah, my people, they're packing everything up. They put their clothes in suitcases, and they put all of the frame things on the wall and in the boxes, and all the cushions from the couch. Oh, wow. Velcro. They're moving. I'm what? Moving. That's what happens when people get a job, when they go to school somewhere else. Sometimes they move to another part of town. Other times, they'll move to another place in the same state, or they'll even, in rare cases, move all the way across the world. That's how I got here. I moved here from Massachusetts all the way down here to Texas. Do you know where you're moving to? Well, I heard my people talking, and they mentioned a place that I'd never heard of called Connecticut. Oh, wow! Connecticut and Massachusetts are right next to each other. You're gonna like it there. Oh yeah? How is it different from being here in Texas? Well, up there in New England, that's what they call it, they have a thing called seasons. You see, in Houston, Texas, it feels like summertime 9 months out of the year. But there, in the fall, all the leaves change color and fall out of the trees. And they have this thing called winter. Winter? What's that? It's when it gets really cold and snow falls from the sky and onto the ground. Snow? What's that? It's cold, white, powdery stuff. And if enough of that cold, white, powdery stuff falls, called snow, they cancel school and work. Oh, that's nice, but I never go anywhere. Oh, but then your people will stay home with you. Oh, I think I like snow. All right, I'm gonna go home now and pack up my stuff and get ready to go. I'll see you later. Bye-bye. So Velcro ran all the way back home, and he was gonna run back upstairs. But before he could get there, he saw two big men walk into his house. And they came out of a big, giant truck. And he stopped, and he hid, and he watched them.
All right, we grab the boxes first and everything else. All right, you get two over there, I'll get this one here. All right, it's heavy, who packed this? Oh my goodness. All right, I'll get this one. Why do these people always have stairs? Oh, this is heavy. Oh my goodness. All right, put it in the truck. All right, we get couch now. Go ahead. I get this side, you get other side. All right, ready. One, two, three. All right, let me fix my hand first. I don't have good grip. All right, let's make it.
Hey, why do you always make me walk backwards down these stairs?
Just go.
And they took everything, and they put it in the big truck. And this made Velcro feel very nervous, because he knew that his people were going to pack everything in the boxes. But he didn't know everything was going to get taken away.
What's happening? Corey didn't say anything about everybody taking everything away. This is weird. Wow. This place is so much bigger with all that stuff in it. Stuff in it. Oh, wow, there's an echo. I sure am going to miss this place.
And with that, Velcro's person came and brought his carrier. Put him inside.
Oh no! Nobody said anything about me having to go into a carrier. I don't want to go! No, stop! Oh no!
And they took him down. downstairs, they went outside, and they loaded everything into the car that couldn't go on the truck. That included Velcro. And while Velcro was waiting, his friends came by one last time to say goodbye.
Well, Velcro, we just wanted to come by and say goodbye, right, babies?
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, we're going to come
back. All right. Oh, goodness. I fell over.
And all of his friends came by, including Charlie. Hey, Velcro, I just wanted to say goodbye. And I want you to remember all the staring tricks that I taught you. And this is something I never said before. You're even a better starer than me. Oh, well, Charlie, that means a lot coming from you. And then Corey said his goodbye. Velcro, you were always so nice to me, even though I was smaller than everybody else. Please, remember if you meet somebody small, to be nice to them, and you can be friends. Thanks, Corey. I'll remember. All right, goodbye. Goodbye. Everybody said their last goodbyes as Velcro's person picked him up and put him into the car. And it was like this. And they phased Velcro's carrier out so he could look out the window. And they were off.
Ladies and gentlemen, I bring you the continental United States
plus Alaska and Hawaii. All right, everyone. Can anyone point out where Texas is on the map? Yep, it's right down there, the big one on the bottom. All right. Now, can anyone point out where Connecticut is on the map? Anybody? Yeah? Okay, it's all the way up here. A little guy right there. All right. So we left pretty late at night. And then when we got to Atlanta, there was a traffic jam. And when we got through Virginia, we started making it through all the other states, like Maryland, toll, Delaware, toll. And then we got to the New Jersey Turnpike, toll, traffic jam. Toll. And we made it all the way to Connecticut. And when we got there, it was very late at night. Here we go. Into the new house. And he could see eyeballs glowing all around. And he got nervous. What are those eyeballs? What's going on? Where are we? This place smells really weird. I wonder if all of our stuff is going to come back. We went upstairs. Velcro went to sleep. And then, the very next morning, the sun rose. And light shone in the new apartment. Velcro got to look around. And then, bright and early, we heard a rumble down the street. It was the moving truck. The movers were there with all of our stuff.
All right, you grab boxes first. Okay, you go. Then I get these other ones. Then we move furniture, okay? Oh, good, no stairs. This will be piece of cake. All right, grab couch, you grab this side, I grab other side. All right. Oh, more, let me fix hand first. Okay, more better.
it started to look like his house again. The couch was in place. The cushions were taken out of the boxes, put into place, just like that. And put the pictures back up on the wall, almost the same way as they were before. They all looked familiar. And that's the funny thing about moving. Even though you get to a new place, it's a lot like your old place because you bring all your stuff with you. So Velcro got really excited and he ran and he looked all around the apartment and he could see, oh, this isn't so bad after all. Pictures are back up. There's a one of me. And look, there's a window for me to look out. All right, I'm gonna walk around and look at the rest of the place. And while he did that, he saw that he had much more room in his new place than he ever had before, including 50 new sleeping spots. This is great. Oh my goodness. Now, I'm just going to jump up here and look out the window and see what I can see. He sat up there and he looked. And while he looked out the window, he saw some new animals out there. And he thought, wow, this is great. New friends. And he saw Otis. And he saw Pumpkin. They were out walking around the backyard, just having a good time. Velcro thought, I better go down there and see if I can make new friends with those kitties. So he got really excited, and he jumped down, and he wanted to go outside.
Meow, 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 let me go outside, let me out now, meow.
So he opened the door, and Velcro ran down the front steps and into his new yard. In that new yard, he saw lots and lots of giant trees. He thought, wow, isn't this great? Look at all these trees. This is a much better backyard. It's so much bigger. Wow, this is getting to be really good. And while he was waiting and looking for new friends, a new friend flew by.
Hi, I'm Velcro.
Hi, Velcro. I'm you the butterfly.
You want to be friends?
Yeah, let's be friends. Follow me, I'll show you around.
Ran, and they ran around, and they played, and they ran, and then all of a sudden they ran in to two new kitties who were out sitting in the yard. And as they ran by, Buick said,
oh no! Those kitties are mean. I can't stay here.
She flew away. Pepper said,
Beulah, where are you going?
Oh, no.
Hey, who are you?
Huh? Hi. My name's Velcro. I'm new here.
Velcro? What kind of accent is that?
Yeah, what is accent is that?
I just moved here from Texas.
Yeah, well, we don't like outsiders like you being around here.
Yeah, we don't like outsiders here.
But in my old neighborhood, I was friends with everybody.
Yeah, well, things are different here, and we don't like kitties with stripes.
Yeah, we don't like stripes.
And this made Velcro very sad. He hung his head. Velcro continued to make his way back to his house, and there, all of a sudden, he ran into even more creatures. There was Skunky Doodle-Doo, and there was Gary the Groundhog, and there was Kevin. He's a raccoon. And they were all just waiting, minding their own business, when Velcro came walking by.
Oh no! It's more mean creatures! I better run!
Ah! Velcro ran away. Skunky Doodle-Doo said, "Hey, wait! We're the ones who were watching you move in last night. Those are glowing eyes."
Oh well, maybe we'll meet them later on.
Yeah, we can meet them later on. And maybe he can eat trash with us later.
Well, I'll eat trash with you.
Yeah, not everybody likes trash.
Velcro ran all the way back to his house. And he was very sad. Even though he had made one new friend, he thought everybody else was mean. And he came in very slow. So I picked him up. I said, "What's wrong? Everything will be okay." But nothing seemed to cheer him up. So I put him on his new favorite spot so he could look out the window. And while he was watching, he saw something that made him lift his spirits. And it was his brand new friend, Beulah Butterfly.
Velcro, what's wrong? Come back out and play with me.
So Velcro got excited once again, and he jumped down off of the furnace and said,
"Meow, meow, let me outside, let me outside, let me outside right now."
Opened the door, and he ran down the steps, and he went to the backyard. And there, he met all kinds of new friends. "Hey! Hey! Over here!"
"Hello?
Hi, I'm Velcro."
"Hi, I'm Skunky Doodle-Doo. Pleased to meet you."
"Oh, that's great. Hey, meet my other friends.
We got Gary.
He's a groundhog."
"Hey, I'm Velcro. Nice to meet you."
"Hey, good to meet you."
"And we got Kevin."
"Hey, what's everybody doing? I didn't know we were having a party. Wait right here. Look, I brought food for everybody. Dig in."
"Oh, thanks for the offer, Kevin, but I'm a very picky eater."
"Oh, okay. That means more for me then.
Hey, I want some too.
All right, dig in."
So they went off and they ate trash together. Well, Skunky Doodle-Doo thought he could introduce Velcro to the rest of the neighborhood.
"Hey, so we got other places that can show you around.
You don't like to eat trash either?"
"No, I don't like trash."
"Yeah, I don't like to eat trash either.
Hey, can I ask you something, Skunky Doodle-Doo? Do you know those other mean kitties, Otis and Pumpkin?"
"Oh yeah, I know them. I try to steer clear of them. They're always very mean to me."
"Actually, that reminds me. Could you help me out with something?"
"Yeah, sure. What are friends for?"
"All right, follow me."
Skunky Doodle-Doo took Velcro over to the neighbor lady's house. There, the neighbor lady, she put out food for all the stray cats, so they had a place to eat.
Yeah, come here.
You see that house?
Yeah, I see it.
Well, the lady puts food out, except she don't like skunks to eat that food. And I love cat food.
I love cat food too.
Do me a favor, be a lookout while I go and eat my fill. Okay, thank you.
No one coming.
All right.
Still nobody.
Oh, that was great.
Oh, I'm glad you could help.
All right, now that I'm full, I'm gonna go take a nap now.
Bye, Velcro.
Bye, Skunky Doodle-Doo.
Velcro was very happy because he had made even more friends today. But while he was waiting and having fun, a couple of other animals showed up.
Hey, I thought I said that you couldn't be in this yard.
Yeah, we said you couldn't be in this yard.
Well, where I come from, everybody can go everywhere.
Well, that's not how we do things here, right?
Yeah, that's not how we do things here.
Well, I know. Why don't I challenge you to a staring contest?
A staring contest?
A staring contest? What's that?
Oh, that's where we just look at each other. And whoever flinches first is the loser.
All right, I'll do it.
So they got started, and he stared, and stared, and stared, and stared, and stared, and stared.
Aha, you flinched!
Oh no! Oh, I'm getting out of here, how embarrassing!
Well, I guess that just leaves me.
All right, well, when do you want to get started on our staring contest?
I don't think so. I don't do staring contests. We're gonna fight.
What?
All right, I just wanna stop right there. Remind you that these are cats. They're animals. And sometimes they will fight. But I'm not saying that any of us need to get violent, okay? All right, let's get started.
But I said I don't wanna fight. Fighting's not right.
But I don't fight.
I said I don't want to fight. Now here's the thing about Velcro. He has the ability to yell very, very loud. When he does, it's scary.
I said I don't want to fight!
Oh, that's scary! I'm running away!
Velcro was feeling very proud of himself, because he scared those other kitties away by outsmarting them. And he's like,
yes, yay, I am so great, I am the same, I am the kitty king and this is my place, I am so great, I am so great, I am the kitty king and this is my place.
And he ran and he pranced all the way home, as happy as could be. And he went into it, you guessed it, his favorite place on top of the furnace. And he looked out the window, watched, surveyed everything, because now he felt like he was the new owner of the backyard. And as he looked out the window, he saw something that was of great concern to him. It was a new kitty. He thought, oh great, they're coming to take over my new yard.
My tummy hurts. Please help me.
Now, Velcro got very fired up about seeing that kitty in his yard. He jumped down and he wanted to go outside.
Meow, meow, let me outside, let me outside, let me outside, right? Meow!
He opened the door and ran down the steps into the yard. And there, in the middle of what he thought was his yard, was a little white kitty.
It feels so good.
Hey, what are you doing here?
Oh,
kitties with stripes. So leave.
Oh, I'm so sorry.
Poor little white kitty left.
Ha 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 ha! I did such a great job guarding my new place.
And then all of a sudden, Velcro saw one of his new friends walking with the poor little white kitty.
My name is Beauty Butterfly. What's your name?
I'm Olive, and I need help.
Well, come along with me, and I'll show you around.
Velcro got really confused, because Beulah, she completely ignored them.
And he said, hey, I thought I did a good job. What's going on?
And all of a sudden, another new friend came out and said, hey, Velcro, we saw what you did.
You did? I did such a great job, didn't I? I guarded this whole place from that bad kitty.
That wasn't good at all, Velcro.
You were so mean.
Do you remember what it was like when those other kitties were mean to you? And Velcro started thinking. He remembered what it was like. And it did not feel very good at all. So now he was confused, because he thought he was doing a good job, but he was just being mean. So he slowly walked home, thinking about everything that just happened. And when he got back to his house, he got very tired from thinking that he was going to go ahead and take a nap. As Velcro napped, he began to dream. He remembered all of his old friends.
Velcro, you gotta be nice to all the little critters. Ain't that right, baby?
Velcro, we saw what you did. That was great.
Yeah,
time to share your trash. And they all got to be great friends, all together, living in the neighborhood. And Funko felt very happy that not only was the big neighborhood have lots of trees and lots of friends to play with, but he was happy knowing that he'd get to have so many more adventures. And there, Beulah,